it is worth pausing at this point just to try to do some practice problems here. So here's an exercise. So here is some machine status. So I've given you the values of some of the registers and the values in some of the locations in memory. So this is the address of a place in memory and the value that is stored there. So assuming that these are all the this is all the information you need in order to answer these questions, what is the value of each of these assembly operands? So I would pause the video and take a couple minutes and see if you can work out what all of these values are going to be. Okay, so these first two are immediate immediate operands, and so they're just the value that's encoded there. We know that they're immediates because they have the dollar sign prefix. So the value of this first one is just 42. The value of the second one is hex 10, which of course is 16. This is a register operand, so the value is just going to be the value of the register. So the current value of REX is hex 100, so that is the value of this operand. This is a memory address, so this is the just the regular base address addressing mode, and so we'll just go to that address in memory and grab whatever value is there. So at location hex 104, the value is hex AB. So that's the value. This is also a memory operand, and we know that because of the parentheses. So this is the indirect addressing mode, and this means to go grab the value of RAX and use that as the effective address. So we will actually end up going to memory at location hex 100 because that is the value of RAX at this point. So the value that is in memory at address hex 100 is hex FF. The next one uses the base plus displacement addressing mode. So we'll take the value of the RAX register and we'll add this fixed offset of 4. So this means that we'll take the value hex 100, we'll add 4 to that, and that means that the effective address is going to be hex 104, which is value hex AB. And then these last two are those indexed addressing modes. So here we have no scale, so we're just going to add RAX and RDX. That'll get us 102 in hex, and then we need to add the fixed offset, so that'll get us to 104, which again gives us the value hex AB. And then down here, we don't have a fixed offset, but we have a scale factor, so we're going to take the second register, multiply by the scale factor. This is the formula that was on a previous slide. And so we'll take that value, which is 2, multiply it by 4, which gets us 8, and then we'll add that to the value of RAX. So that gives us the effective address of 108, and the value there is hex 13. So as another question, so assume that the RAX register stores the address of the data that we want to access. So which of the following operand specifiers could not be used to access the data? So pause the video and take a moment to see what you think the answer to this question is. So the point of this question is really to point out that there are various ways of doing things in assembly, and some of those ways are equivalent to others. The answer to this question actually should be fairly straightforward if you just recognize that four of these answers are memory operands and one of them is a register operand. So if we're trying to access data in memory at some sort of address, we're not going to be wanting to use a register operand. We're going to want to use a memory operand. So A is definitely not an operand that we could use to access the data that we want. So that is the correct answer to this question. And then the other point of this question is, again, to point out that the rest of these are actually all equivalent. And you should convince yourself of this by going and looking at the formulas from the addressing modes slide and convincing yourself that all these will work out to the same effective address. So for instance, here we're using an effective address of RAX. Here we're using an effective address of RAX plus 0, which of course is just RAX. And similarly for the indexed addressing modes.